Well, Mickey, 3-1 and a top performance.
Yeah, played very well, really professional, took our chances, well, eventually took some of the chances that we created. But to come here, we knew it was going to be a tough tie. We knew that we would have to put on a professional performance because Halifax are doing very well in the league. So we always knew that coming over here was going to be difficult and we had to be very professional in order to try and get a result.
That's exactly what it was, a fully professional performance today, and moved the ball very well from the off. Must be pleased by the way they played as well today.
Yeah, obviously, but there's always things that we want to get better at, and there was things that we spoke about at half time. Come into the second half and looked more like what we'd worked on in training. But it was good. There was good areas all over, like we've said in other results. There's been good performances in certain areas of the team. It was the same today, and there was always stuff that we'd want to get better at. But it's fantastic for the lads to get through the FA Cup into the next round.
And the moments at the start of the match, where we've seen a penalty save and an own goal, a game where in the past you may have seen Tranmere crumble, but they stayed strong, the attitude was fine, and they fought through and they got the victory then.
Yeah, they did, yeah. We've spoke a lot about that. And you've heard me saying many, many times on here, you stick to the plan no matter what's going on. We stick to what we believe in and what we've worked on all weekend. To be fair to the boys, they continue to do that. Scored a good goal just before half-time. We could have had a few more, let's be honest. We had a number of 1v1s that we'll be disappointed about not taking, but that would be nitpicking all round the performances that we asked the boys to do in the game what the game asked them. They pulled it off.
Now you're not the person to single out individuals, Mickey, but is that Ollie Milburn's best game for Sammy today?
I think he's been great since he's been here. He's been flawless since he came into Tranmere. I'm sure the MD that knows anything about midfield players knows how good a player he is. Sometimes he gets brushed over because of maybe results or whatever, but he's been terrific ever since he's came, and he's been a real good addition to the group for us, and we're really pleased to have him here.
And a goal scored from a direct free kick, something that we haven't seen many of over the past few years at Sammy, but an absolute top quality free kick from Liam Radosh.
Yeah, he's well capable, he's got a fantastic left foot, isn't he? We're delighted to see it going in, especially at that time that it went in. So really pleased to see that going in, but we know he's got great qualities. And he added a goal to a very good performance.
How important is it to take this performance today in the form from the Cup match today into the league next week?
We've been playing well for a while now. That's what I keep on saying to everybody. It's difficult because I'm the manager and I have to look at the whole performance of every game. And yeah, the results are important, but there's been really good things that have happened since the start of this season. It was about putting it all together. We have played very well and defended well at times and attacked at times and took our chances and all the rest of it. So it's nothing that I've seen today that we haven't been doing. It's just that today we've taken our chances, defended very, very well and managed the game out the way it should be done.
And the first time Sam, you're qualified for the FA Cup since you've been in the non-leagues. Is there something you're proud of, take it back into the FA Cup proper?
Yeah, absolutely, because the club needs to be competing as much as it can, as far into cup competitions as possible, to keep the momentum moving forward for the club. So it's a little bit of excitement for the fans. Now we'll go into the draw and hopefully get a favourable tie, and it's something for us to be excited about.
Towards the end of the match, we've seen Dylan Motley-Henry limp off. Is he okay? No, it's early days, but any signs of what the injury is?
Well, as it's early days, but I think it was just a bit of cramp. We have to remember him and Jerry are 19 years of age, so it's young lads playing at these levels. You see the different intensity. That's the reason why they come out on loan, to get the experience that they're getting here. We are delighted to have them here, and we'll continue to keep moving them forward and keep improving them.
That's something that you've asked for all season. In fact, since I first met you, you mentioned about not having 7 subs. The first time today, yeah, you've played to where you've had 7 subs.
Well, it certainly makes things easier, doesn't it? It gives you more choice on the bench. It's probably more than we're used to. It keeps everybody happy because they all get kitted up. So it certainly gives you more options. So, yeah, we're pleased about that. All the credit goes to the players today, every one of them, and the togetherness of the group, both the ones that played and didn't, because it's important that Tranmere keep winning games.
And we always praise the fans, Mickey, but 360 Tranmere fans today coming to the show, and they sounded like it was 3,000 fans at some point today. They were absolutely outstanding.
Yeah, they were brilliant. They always are. We never take them for granted and always try and sure that we're grateful for the support that they give us, even when it's been a wee bit tougher the last few weeks. They've always got right behind us and know that they've got a massive part to play. They know that they've got a manager and a group of players that's massive about getting it right for Tranmere. You know that. We're working with socks off to try and keep doing that. We haven't achieved anything yet, but we just keep trying to win games of football and keep making players better and keep putting performances on that represents this fantastic club well. But certainly the fans put a massive part, like they always do today. And they can go and enjoy the weekends and see what the draw is next week. But that's the excitement that we want to try and give them.
And dare to dream Tranmere in the velvet bag for the first time for the year as well, don't we?
Yeah, thank you. Cheers.
Confidence and momentum you've mentioned a few times just recently. How does that sort of show itself on the pitch as far as you're concerned? What difference do you see in your players when they've got that confidence and a bit of momentum?
Well, obviously you see that the scientifically, if you want to go that deep into it, they run harder, they run faster, they play with a lot more freedom, we score goals, you see them doing their jobs that we practice so hard on the training ground, you see them pulling that off. So all of that, but the togetherness, it builds togetherness, and we know that we have a formula that can get us results, we know that. So if you get that togetherness and we know that we have that formula, then it builds confidence, which is always a big deciding factor at any football club. So to have that building, which can only be built by results, is obviously very pleasing.
The glib reply of a manager when you get knocked out of the FA Cup, we can concentrate on the league. That's not the case.
No.
But we saw with Lincoln last season, you know, and how that helped their season. Certainly they've had money, haven't they, from their cup run to be able to build this season. So they have a really big impact on the club if you have a good run.
Absolutely. We've never said anything other than the next game is always important for Tranmere. We have to win the next game. The standards here are what we accept, that you've got to play well and you've got to win games of football here. We embrace that. We take that on the chin when that doesn't happen. We know the standards here are very, very high. We've got a group of players that know that they have to meet their standards. It was just another game that we had to win. Saturday now, we go again and we do the same. We represent the club properly and play properly and go and try and win again.
Yeah, and team selection becomes easier as well because you have that consistency. Don't you? Players know what they've got to do to step up and get themselves into the starting 11.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not going against every one of your questions and not agreeing with them. No, it doesn't. We'll always try and pick a team without being reckless that we believe will give the opposition problems. I trust all my group to play all the time. That's why they've been brought here, to play first team football. We all know that. So they know that I trust them, and when they have to go on and give a performance or a certain type of performance and a certain job for the team, that's what they'll do. Regardless of what the result is before, if we think that there's a player that's better suited to a certain job, then we would pick him to do that.
I just ask, could Norwood's goal have come at a bad time, given the chances that you've missed early on?
Yeah, we'd be standing here saying, I think there's no doubt, the amount of chances that we had, 1v1s and all the rest of it, they were starting to rack up again. But we won't brush over it, we won't polish over it, if you like. We know that we need to be clinical and take the chances when they come along, but certainly to score three goals away from home in an FA Cup tie, I can't be too greedy. And the amount of chances that were created, I think that's what it's all about. And I think when we are creating the chances, we can do no more as a coaching staff. That's the ability of people who get into the areas to take the chances, and it wasn't just the strikers, we got other people in. So it's up to their coolness or what they've done in the past to get into these situations and score us the goals.